Good morning, MBHS, and welcome to the newest edition of the T-Bird News. I'm Jake Newbig.
I'm Brandon Stimson.
And we are the Bowtie Bros.
Hey, Jake, do you smell that?
Pancakes, bacon, potatoes, and best of all, whipped cream.
It sounds and smells just like it did at the Hurricane Relief breakfast.
It sure does. Students brought in canned goods to help the people struggling after the effects of all the hurricanes.
Charles was there for the scoop.
Here I am standing outside Ms. Lanzoni's room while Mrs. Danner's advisory eats her breakfast for being the winners for the hurricane relief. Now, excuse me, I'm gonna repeat the bacon.
Silent talk, silent talk, silent talk. Gonna do it for me. Now watch me whip, kill it. Now watch me nae-nae. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip, watch me nae-nae.
As the winners were eating their delicious breakfast, here's what they had to say.
Okay. Now watch me whip, whip.
What is those you eating?
Potatoes with cheese.
How's it going, Julia?
So great.
How's the pancakes?
I'm fantastic. Thanks for asking, Carl.
We'd like to congratulate Mrs. Danner's advisory group for contributing the most donations to the hurricane drive at North Brantford High School. Nice job. Great job following our mission statement and the PBI's expectations at North Brantford High School.
I'm Charles Walcott, reporting for T-Bird News.
Break the nut and break your legs. Break them.
Thanks, Charles. Speaking of food, how about Miss Artize's Art of Living class with the annual Cake Wars? Those cakes are always so presentable.
Here's Mike Berdotti with the recipe for success.
A few weeks ago, Bridges held their annual Halloween Cake Wars, where groups had to create the cake that got the most votes from the judges and faculty members, including Mr. Grodz and Mr. Steffler.
You have to get it from right there, because that's the front.
Every group had amazing cakes, but the one who came out on top was Haunted Graveyard, made by Haley Murphy, Dylan Duffy, Leah Campagna, and Summer Graveyard. I asked the winning team what their favorite part about the competition was.
Probably frosting it, because the frosting kept like pulling the cake off.
Do you like the pumpkins in the gummy worms?
Yeah.
Decorating. Everything about decorating.
The competition was fierce, but in the end, it was for fun, and each team was able to take a piece of their cake home. For T-Bird News, this is Mike Berdotti.
And now, John Pellegrino comes to you from the cabaret consisting of the North Brantford Chamber and Concert Choir.
Boy bands, grunge rock, Nicktoons. What's not to love about the 90s and 2000s? Members of Chorus and Chamber Choir put on a nostalgic night in the cafeteria, performing the best of the era in this year's annual cabaret. With raffles, fine cuisine, and of course, fantastic performances, attendees had a stupendous night. The audience weren't the only ones having a great time, but so did these chorus members. Let's hear what they loved about the event.
Honestly, the favorite thing about the cabaret is just like having a good time with our friends. We're singing and making great music, and the crowd's really into it, so that's awesome.
The food. Obviously.
The whole atmosphere of it all, being able to hang out with your friends and just go up and sing and have fun, it's great.
Yeah, kind of like what they said too, it's very fun. You should come to it next year if you can.
I did Do You Know What I'm Seeing by Panic at the Disco as a duet with Emma Schreiber.
Ian and I, we both did a, we did the cover of Fountains of Wayne, Stacey's Mom. Baby, can't you see? Stacey's mom has got it going on. She's all I want, and I'm waiting for so long. Honestly, my favorite cover had to be John Buckley's Feeling Good. You know, he has a lot of soul in his voice, and you can just tell he's having a really good time up there, and that's good to see.
John Buckley just that cover.
And I'm feeling good.
Oh, my favorite cover by far was Ian McClay and Nick Federico, who sang Stacey's Mom. It was fantastic.
And mine was
was Emily and Christina singing Hey Dear Delilah. Oh, we have it all. Oh, it's what you do to me. Oh, it's what you do. I liked Brittany and Brandon's duet.
If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?
There were so many other talented singers and great performances. If you'd like to see more, the full cabaret is on the NBHS T-Bird News YouTube channel. The link is in the description. I'm John Pellegrino, back to the studio.
That was great, John. So awesome to see our choir students display their talents in front of everyone.
You know what also happened just recently?
What?
The Kaleidoscope Cafe.
Very true. And weren't you there to cover it?
Yes. Here's more on the event.
On Thursday, November 9th, the Kaleidoscope Club held a Kaleidoscope Cafe. I was there to capture some of the footage.
With so many creative students here at North Brantford High School, what better way to show them off by holding a Kaleidoscope Cafe? Students were able to present their artistic abilities by reading poetry, singing, playing instruments, and doing stand-up comedy.
It turns the once dark forest into a light show as he runs to safety.
And the angels like a pagan.
Remember how everyone was obsessed about that coffee last year? No. We still are.
Draw one!
Waiter, waiter, burgle.
We also had the opportunity to sing to Micro Buffo in celebration of his 17th birthday.
Happy birthday to you!
We did one in the spring last year, and together we, as a group for Kaleidoscope, we felt that we needed to do another one in the winter, and it worked out perfectly.
It was an all-around fun and successful night for everyone who attended. All the students and teachers enjoyed each other's talents and really banded together to make the night come together.
We want to thank Ms. Dodds and everyone from the Kaleidoscope Club for hosting this amazing event. For T-Bird News, I'm Brandon Stimson.
The month of November is a special month to many citizens of the United States. Those citizens wear the red, white, and blue, and proudly served our country with their lives.
Without a doubt, those men and women are the true heroes around the world. I personally want to thank every citizen who put their lives on the line every day to serve our country.
Here's Gloria Carr with more on Veterans Day.
As many students know, Veterans Day is a time to be thankful. Thankful for those who have served and those who are still serving in the United States military.
ROTC program, I spent a year there.
On November 10th, we had our annual assembly where veterans came and told stories about their time in the military.
I have the opportunity to meet plenty of different individuals. Protection of our freedom and my family.
Say, you know, definitely part of, you know, being part of the Marine Corps is something that isn't for everybody, but it's something that you want to dig down and deep and definitely earn it. One thing in the Marine Corps, it's never given, it's always earned. So for somebody that really wants it, they're going to have to work, you know, and definitely earn it. But once you earn it, you're going to get something, you know, paid for 10 times. So it's definitely, you know, the outcome at the end of, you know, working for it is definitely worth it.
It was nice to see the students make a connection with local veterans. Thank you to those who are currently serving or have ever served. In North Brantford for Fox 61 Student News, I'm Gloria Carr.
We have a lot of creative and amazing writers in our school.
The Shed Conference is a way for the best writers of the shoreline to come together and create great products.
Take it away, Connor.
Ms. Dodds heads up the Shed Conference here at NBHS. The Shed Conference gives students the opportunity to express themselves through different forms of writing, such as fiction, poetry, journalism, and songwriting.
The Shed Writing Conference, it stands for Shoreline Heads of English Departments, and what it is we have 7 or 8 local authors every year who specialize in poetry, fiction, journalism, and songwriting, and they come to our school and conduct workshops in their genres with students from NBHS, NBIS, and all the other high schools in the shoreline. So it's a really great opportunity for not only the North Brantford students, but also all of the other high schoolers in the shoreline who enjoy creative writing, because they get to work with authors who are published in that particular genre, so they get to learn skills for writing that they might not necessarily learn in their regular English classrooms.
I really like that one. I like it.
bragging to my school friends in the first grade.
My favorite part was the fact that I could take a poetry workshop because I love poetry, and I got to learn from a really well-known, accomplished poet. She taught us methods that I would have never thought to do, and I think it's really going to help me improve my own writing.
When we work with other towns around the shoreline, it kind of brings everyone together so that we can work together on poetry, songwriting, and really strengthens the community of the shoreline.
The Shed Conference allows students from all its schools throughout the shoreline to express their literary ideas. For T-Bird News, I'm Connor Pollack.
The last student spotlight was focused on Anthony Leone. Now we shift gears to Emmy Norton.
Emmy is involved in many things in and outside of school. Here she is to tell you more.
The new segment on T-Bird News is Student Spotlight. This week's Student Spotlight is Emmy Norton. She's involved with a lot of things inside of school and also outside of school. Here's a few things about her.
In school right now, I'm taking AP Biology, AP Calculus, AP Physics, and American Protest, which is a UConn ECE class. I'm also enrolled in Consumer Economics and Writing for College.
Those were the inside school. Here are the outside of school.
I'm the captain of the field hockey and lacrosse team, and I'm also on the ice hockey team. I'm a representative for our class and student council, and I'm the president of National Honor Society.
As you can see, she's involved with a lot of things in and outside of school. I'm Jake Newbig, reporting for T-Bird News.
Brandon, besides me, what are you most thankful for?
I'm most thankful for all of my family and my friends.
That's good. Here's Morgan to tell you what the students and teachers are thankful for.
Last week on November 23rd, people everywhere celebrated Thanksgiving with their family and friends.
Thanksgiving is a time where we all rejoice in what we are thankful for. Here's what some students and teachers are grateful for this time of year.
I'm thankful for my family. I'm thankful to have a really good education here. And then I'm grateful for my cheer team and my best friends.
Well, I'm thankful for that this is like the holiday season where we can really create some awesome music with Christmas carols and have just a lot of fun in our class. Everyone loves Christmas carols, so it's going to be a really fun time with our students to be able to create some wonderful music with the community.
I'm thankful for my friends and family and my mom always being there for me for everything and anything.
I am most thankful for my students who are so well behaved and excellent this year. I'm also thankful for my family and my friends, and my health this year is really awesome. So that's what I'm most thankful for this year.
I hope everyone enjoyed their Thanksgiving break with family and friends. Next up, the Christmas special. From T-Bird News, I'm Morgan Odies.
That's all for this T-Bird News. We hope you have an amazing Thanksgiving break.
And eat a lot of turkey. For T-Bird News, I'm Jake Newbig.
And I'm Brandon Stimson. See you next time.